This is Victor. I'm here with a new unit in depth, and this time I want to review the new Lord of War robot Gilliman. So one of the most iconic characters in the Imperium, if not the most. I think the most influential after the Emperor today. So here we have, it's costing 350 points and it's a Lord of War. See, it's not an HQ. Of course, it's expected as he's really a beast. So he has weapon skill 9, ballistic skill 6, strength 6, toughness 6 wounds, initiative 6, 6 attacks, leadership 10, 2 plus saves. He's a monstrous creature and he's unique, of course. He has adamantium will, chapter tactics, so he's ultramarine. Have eternal warrior, so cannot be instant killed. He's fearless, have feel no pain, have fleet, precision shots, precision strikes, and preferred enemy chaos. And chaos is including all the codecs that have chaos, like chaos demons, chaos space marines, and Khorne Demokin. He's the Lord Commander of the Imperium, so friendly units from the armies of the Imperium reroll failed morale check and fear and pinning that while Gilliman is on the battlefield. He is the Primarch of the 13th Legion, so means that you can choose to enact one of these doctrines, one of the doctrines, Devastator, Assault, or Tactical Doctrines per battle. And this is on top of the doctrines that you can already have because of the detachment or any other thing, and is affecting all the Ultramarines on the battlefield. He also have the unwieldy will, so robot Gilliman leadership is not subject to negative modifiers of any kind when they make the and he may reroll failed the 90 witch test. So he is normally 90 witch on 5 plus if his objective of the spell, and on top he's rerolling, so he's giving quite a good resistance to enemy secret powers. He's equipped with the Emperor's Sword and the Hammer of Dominion. So the Emperor's Sword have Strength 10, AP 1, is melee, armor bane, conclusive, soul blaze, have the touch of the Emperor, and have the whirling flames. So the touch of the Emperor is that if you hit with a 6, you have a strength D instead of 10, strength 10. And the whirling flames is that you can, so instead of making your normal 6 attacks, you can do as many attacks as enemy models within 1 inch. If there are 2 units in close combat, you split and then you count how many models you have from one unit and how many models you have from the other unit. So, but he's attacking all the models within 1 inch. So if he's surrounded, he can really do a lot of attacks. Normally he will hit on, more likely in on 3 plus, because we'll have more or better close combat abilities than most of the enemies. Maybe only the Blood Sister is have more or less the value than some assassins. He also have the Hand of Dominion, and the Hand of Dominion is a weapon that have range 24, strength 6, AP 2, is assault 3, and ready. So it's a super strong stone boulder. And then on top he's equipped with the Armor of Fate, that is giving the 2 plus armor save plus a 3 plus invulnerable save, plus when he's slain on 4 plus you put a counter, and on 4 plus next turn he's back with the 3 wounds, so making him really very resilient. So this guy, and then I forgot, Warlord trait, he has absolute mastery, means that robot Gilliman has all of the common traits from the Warhammer 40k rules. So he's a unit, a guy that is a really beast in close combat. The only drawback, he's a monstrous creature that is walking. Although he has fleet and you can reroll to run, he is not very fast. So most likely you will need a type of psychic power to be able to move him, or he will only engage in close combat about in most likely in the turn 3. So if I will be very difficult he is assaulting in turn 2 or yeah, impossible in turn 1 if he's not using any type of special ability. Of course you will have outflanking some of your units, so I guess he can give outflanking to himself, so he can outflank if it's needed, because he has all the warlord traits, and if I'm not wrong there is one warlord trait that gives outflanking to these three units. So you can give outflanking to these three units and you can give outflanking to himself when he's arriving from outflanking. Anyway, he only he cannot assault, and even if it's arriving in turn 2 you will not be able to assault until turn 3. So it's a really is a guy that wants to be in close combat. He's going to be very strong, and he's going to be almost going to kill almost everything that is touching. He's touching with a strength 10. He has the power to deal even with, I would say, with Dread Knights, or he can deal with any type of super heavy, even super heavy vehicles. You have to be careful because you still will, if you receive the strength 6D weapon, you will still receive a lot of wounds and they can kill you because you will not have any type of save. But he is going to be really difficult. So in close combat is going to be almost impossible to stop. And I guess in one point he will arrive in close combat. It's also quite difficult to kill. You need to invest a lot of shooting. You have 6 wounds with Eternal Warrior, with 2 plus armor save and 3 plus invulnerable save. So 3 plus invulnerable save means that most of the times you don't need to hide him behind cover, because normally the cover will not be as good as his invulnerable save. And on top he has Feel No Pain, so he will even deny some of the savings that he failed with a 5 plus. So making him quite resilient. So if you want to kill him even with weapons that have AP 2 or better, you will need in the order, so just to make 6 wounds you will need in the order of 18 shots. But you know, if you add Feel No Pain, means that you're losing 1/3 of these 6 shots. So you will need, you will need to add in the order of 24 shots to be able to kill Robot Gilman. So making him quite resilient, we're talking about in the order of 24 shots of strength 8, sorry, of strength, quite high strength, because I have toughness 6, so have to be in the order of strength 6 upper to be quite sure, and have to be, have to be AP 2 or 1. So it's really it's able to resist a lot of shooting from the enemy thanks to the invulnerable save on the 2 plus armor save and also the toughness 6, so making him quite resilient. It's a slow, it's a close combat beast, it's quite resilient, and the enemy will need to commit a lot of shooting to him if he wants to kill this guy. I think he can deal with most of the threats that we have on the battlefield. He can deal with Dread Knights, he can deal with the sorry, with the Imperial Knights. He can deal with several enemy that can be difficult sometimes, and can even deal, he alone can even challenge Star, he alone is like a Death Star unit. So he alone is like a Death Star unit in close combat. The most negative part is he cannot be put in vehicle because he's a monstrous creature, and he cannot. He's quite slow. He's not a flying monstrous creature, so he can be quite slow on the battlefield. Maybe it's good to look at that. The warlord traits. Know what's coming to my mind. If you have outflanking, this can help you to put him in close combat. Another option is to use a psyker that is teleporting him in turn 1 next to the enemy, so in turn 2 you can be able to assault. You can expose him quite a little bit. The only thing, you have to be careful with the bishop. You don't want to kill him just because you don't have bishop. And that's all what I want to share here. So I just really want to share and talk about one of, I think, strongest no models for the Imperium. I think 350 points is not too expensive for a character that is really a beast in close combat. I can dish a lot of damage. On top, he will be quite easy to deploy if we use some of the formations from the book. Okay, I think it will not be so difficult, or you can deploy him as with a normal detachment because you can put one Lord of War. But if I'm not wrong, here there is a detachment that we can put. Need to check. This one, oh, it's not here. So, but I think he's quite strong. He's quite and he's quite a good unit, I would say. So that's all what I want to share. Please let me know what do you think about Robot Gilliman. But I really think he's a beast in close combat. A little bit slow, but I think the points that you pay, you get quite. You can make him quite efficient. You have to find the right objective. Of course, if you get stuck with Robot Gilliman again, chaff of the enemy, you're going to misuse the points. He has to go ahead and try to deal with the strong enemy units. He has to go to deal with Death Stars, he has to deal with Demon Princes, he has to deal with Walkers, he has to deal with Imperial Knights or Chaos Imperial Knights and all these type of things. And that's all for now. So please leave the comments below. Give a like if you like these videos, let me know if you like these unit reviews. And as usual, thanks a lot for watching and see you later. Bye!